In this video, we look at solder flux and board cleaning processes for SMT assembly. This is solder paste. It consists of a tacky material called flux with tiny balls of solder mixed in. The solder could be leaded or lead-free. Solder paste is applied to the metal areas of the bare printed circuit board, for example by using a stencil like this. The flux in the paste has two jobs. One, it cleans the metal areas to remove any oxidation and prepare them for soldering. Two, it temporarily holds the SMT components in position as they are placed on the board and go into the reflow oven. In the reflow oven, most of the flux evaporates as the solder melts, flows, and then solidifies to form permanent mechanical and electrical bonds between the components and the board. After reflow, there will still be some flux residue on the board, even though you usually can't see it. What you do about the residue depends on what kind of flux was used. If you used water-soluble flux, you'll have to wash it off. This flux is mildly corrosive as it goes down, and remains corrosive after reflow. Ions in the residue can lead to dendrite growth, causing electrical shorts and product failure months or years later. If you use no clean flux, on the other hand, the residue can stay on the board. This flux is inert when applied, becomes active only when heated in the reflow oven, and then returns to its inert state as it cools. So you save time, labor, and money by eliminating the board cleaning step. So why would we ever use water-soluble flux? The most common reason is when we want to protect the final assembly by applying a conformal coating. Any residue on the board under the coating may eventually chip off and cause gaps in the protection. So in this case, we use a water-soluble flux and a controlled process to remove the flux residue. This aqueous cleaner uses hot, deionized water to thoroughly wash all areas of the boards, including underneath large surface mount components. For process control, we use an ionograph. After washing a board, we submerge it in an alcohol solution. As mentioned earlier, water-soluble flux residue contains ions, and these will dissolve into the solution and change its conductivity. Measuring this change shows us how much flux residue remained on the board after washing. Regular monitoring of the qualified cleaning process with computerized records of board cleanliness makes it easy for us to track our historical data and demonstrate process control. For any PCB assembly project, especially if your boards will be conformally coated, talk with your contract manufacturer about the type of flux they will use and what controlled cleaning processes they have in place to ensure the long-term reliability of your product.